Hello everyone, welcome to Code and Learn. In this video, we are going to look at how to shut down our HTTP server gracefully. What we have here is just listen and serve. That is, if there's any error during listen and serve, we should exit, but we don't account for when the application is stopped manually like it would be done in a Kubernetes cluster. That is, by sending a signal to our running process to terminate. These signals are usually sigterm, sigquit, or siginterrupt. To achieve our goal, we are going to use error groups. Let us look at their documentation. The error group package is provided by the golang sync package. So it's another package inside the sync package. Package error group provides synchronization, error propagation, and context cancellation for groups of coroutines working on subtasks of a common task. Internally, this is related to wait group. This is exactly what we want. We want to start two coroutines, one to listen and serve, and the other one to catch all the signals that may end our process. Once a signal is cached, we want to initiate graceful shutdown of our server. You may ask why we want to do a graceful shutdown. Graceful shutdown helps us process the in-flight request that our server is serving. So there may be a request to create a news object, but if we terminate our server in between, it may lead to bad data. There could be also cases in your application where you are performing a transaction, that is, performing multiple steps that all need to be completed to get to the end stage. If the server shuts down during one of the processes, this may lead to bad data. The function that we are going to use is withContext. WithContext returns a new group and an associated context derived from the passed in context. The derived in context is cancelled the first time a function passed to the go returns a null error or the first time wait returns, whichever occurs first. So we are going to create goroutines using the go method on the group, which calls a given function in a new goroutine. It blocks until the new goroutine can be added, without the number of active goroutines in the group exceeding the configured limit. The first call to return a null error, that is, the first goroutine to return a null error, cancels the group context if the group was created with context. The error will be returned by wait. To understand this better, let us go back to the code. Here, first I'm going to create an error group. So I can say error grp or error group context, which is the context returned by the withContext function. We will use error group, that is error group dot with context. For context, we are just going to use parent context, which is provided by context.background. So now let's start a goroutine using this error group. Error group dot go accepts a function which returns error. Inside a function, we can move this, that is listen and serve, like this. Now here we want to log the error and also return it. So we will just say return fmt errorf error starting server. If there's no error, we return null. So if you read the documentation, listen and serve will be a blocking call. That is, it will continue listening and serving the incoming request until there's error with the connection or the listening. So in one goroutine, we are starting this. In the next goroutine, we are going to listen for the shutdown signals. So I'm going to say error group.go same function. We are going to listen to the signal provided by the signal.notify, which is another package provided by the Go standard lib. First, let me create a channel that will be used to transfer the signals. It's a channel of type os.signal. I'm going to make it a buffer channel of capacity 1 so that writing to it is non-blocking. Now, what we can do is use the signal package from os.signal and notify. It accepts two parameters. First is the signal channel and then a list of signals that we want to listen on to. We are going to listen to syscall sigint, that is interrupt, syscall sigterm, and syscall quit. So these are the three signals we are going to listen to. If your application requires to listen to more signals, you can add them here. Now we are going to do select and then listen on to the sig channel, that is case signal from the sig channel. If there is one, this means we have initiated the shutdown of the server. For that, I'm just going to use log.info and say signal received, signal, and then the signal. This call here will be blocking. That is, it will block until we have a signal on the sig channel or a value on the sig channel. We want to clean up after this code routine if the error group context is canceled. So I can just use error group context done, and that's it. Now, if this blocking call resolves, that means we have received a signal to shut down our server. So we are going to do that gracefully. I'm going to create a new context, that is context with timeout, the cancel function, context with timeout. Here we are going to use the group error context or error group context and provide a time for graceful shutdown of our server. So we can say 5 into time.second, but you can update it as per your requirements. Let us just defer the cancel function call here. Now I am going to add a log for another statement that will say initiating graceful shutdown. Then we are going to use the method shutdown on the server that we created earlier. So on this server we are going to use shutdown, so server.shutdown, and provide it with our context. If you read the documentation, shutdown gracefully shuts down the server without interrupting any active connection. And this is what we want. Shutdown works by first closing all open listeners, then closing all idle connection, and then waiting indefinitely for connection to return to idle, and then shutdown. If the provided context expires before the shutdown is complete, shutdown returns the context error. Otherwise, returns the error return from closing the underlying listeners. So in a sense, we are giving it a timeout of cleaning up all the connection in 5 seconds using the context with timeout. If error not is equal to nil, return fmt error f error graceful shutdown. Otherwise, we just return nil. So these are our two goroutines that we are starting using error group. They are related since one is used for listening and serving and the other one is used to listen for signals to shut down our server. Now the last thing we need to do is fire off these coroutines. We are going to use the wait method on the group to do that. If error is equal to error group dot wait, error not is equal to nil, log error. I'm just going to say error running and then error, and that's it. So that's all we require to initiate a graceful shutdown. Now let's start our server, make run. It is erroring out because we don't have any database server running locally. So I'm just going to comment this out and provide nil for db just for the test run. Make run. So our server is now running. Now if we do control C, that is provide the process a signal to shutdown, let's see what happens. Let me just remove the option to add the source and try again. Clear the console, make run. So the server is now running and let's shut it down with control C. And as you can see, it's initiating a graceful shutdown. Before that, we received a signal to shut down the server. And then we proceed ahead to shut down. This is returning an error because we have no longer an open server or a working server. It didn't take any time here to shut down gracefully because we are not serving any request. But in a production grade server, where you have multiple requests being served at a time, this ensures that all active requests are being served properly before the server is shut down. That's it for this lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding.